Jesus was tired from a long walk through Samaria. He sat down by Jacob's well while his disciples were into town to buy food. Usually all the women came to get water in the morning. Even though it was late in the day, one woman came alone to the well. "Give me a drink," Jesus said. The woman was surprised. "Why ask me for water?" she asked. "You are a Jew, and I am a Samaritan." During Jesus' time, Jews and Samaritans were not friends. Jesus told her that if she knew who was speaking to her, she would ask him for a drink. He told her that he had living water. The woman spoke again. "You don't have a bucket, and the well is deep. Where do you get this living water? Are you greater than Jacob, who gave us this well?" Jesus explained, "Everyone who drinks this water will get thirsty again, but anyone who drinks the water I give will never be thirsty again." Jesus was speaking about eternal life forever with God. The woman said, "Sir, give me this water so I won't get thirsty and have to come to this well again." "Bring your husband," Jesus said. The woman told Jesus that she did not have a husband. Jesus said, "That is true." The woman was amazed that Jesus knew about her past. Jesus also explained that God wants people to worship him. "When the Messiah comes," said the woman, "he will explain everything." Jesus told her that he was the Messiah. At that point, the woman left her water jar and hurried to town. She told the townspeople, "Come meet someone who knows everything about me," she exclaimed. "Could he be the Messiah?" Many Samaritans from the town believed in Jesus because of what the woman told them. They asked Jesus to stay with them, and he stayed for 2 days. Later, the people said that they now believe Jesus was the Savior because they heard him themselves.
Mac Truman here with breaking news. As is the case here at Mooseberry Academy for the very, very, very gifted, another science project has gone haywire. We go now to the culprit.
Yes, it was my fault. Again. But at least I didn't make robots that turned evil this time.
What exactly did you create?
I created a rubber magnet.
What's so dangerous about a magnet made of rubber?
No, a magnet that attracts rubber. Then I left it in room 202, which is where the gossip club meets. Immediately, all their shoes flew off their feet and are now stuck to the magnet.
The Gossip Club students have only suffered minor bumps and scrapes, but they're all walking around barefoot. And unfortunately, there doesn't seem to be any way to demagnetize the shoes. This is a big problem. Several feet long, to be exact. Get it? Feet? Shoes?
Huh? Kablamo! I don't know what I would do without my shoes. Wait. I'd make a stunt. I'd walk barefoot. Across hot coals. Blindfolded.
Why does it matter if the coals are blindfolded?
I'd be blindfolded, not the coals.
Oh.
Stunts aside, most people need their shoes. Especially with Mooseberry's cold, cold floors. So, who will rise to the occasion and help these poor souls from the Gossip Club?
As the Gospel Club's official spokesperson, I have to say that on behalf of the Gospel Club and Paris, who started the club, we are unable to support the Gossip Club at this time.
But isn't the Gospel Club dedicated to sharing God's love?
Great question, Mac. While yes, our official stance is that we share God's love, there are limits to who can receive that love. And since gossip isn't a godly trait, we can't support them in any way. Not even with shoes. Sorry.
If a club in need can't depend on the Gospel Club for shoe help, where can they turn?
I've recently started my own club, the Stephanie Does What She Wants Club, and Stephanie wants to help the Gossip Club with their shoes.
What a bold statement! But this sounds like a loving thing to do. I mean, why would an evil genius like you want to do something like that?
I am an evil genius, but my purpose is to allow me to do whatever I want, even if it isn't evil.
And there you have it, an evil genius willing to help those in need, when the club dedicated to God's love isn't.
This is like
embarrassing. I shouldn't have let Nelly speak for me or the club, and it's like super weird that Stephanie is the one who made me see the truth. Whether it's my club or me personally, I shouldn't decide who does or doesn't receive God's love. My job as a Christian is to help anyone in need. It doesn't matter if I agree with them or not. If I help find them shoes, I'm not supporting gossip, I'm showing love.
And what will you do to help?
I'm a fashion genius. I'm sure I can create something effective and stylish faster than Stephanie can.
Fine by me. I'm kind of bored with my club already anyway. I don't need a club to do whatever I want. That's just being me.
It looks like the Gossip Club's feet will soon be shooed. And experts are disposing of Jasper's magnetic monstrosity as we speak. But they won't be disposing of my unquenchable thirst for 32-ounce bottle of truth. Until next time, I'm Mac Truman, and don't you forget it.